Most High, the intermediary spirits of the universe, and as well as our Ogun, or bloodline ancestors, and then our racial ancestors, which are the larger Ogun. So I'm going to start by invoking the presence of the great supreme deity, supreme consciousness, known by many names, Inyame, Amin Ra, Chukwu, Olofin, Olodumare, Jehovah God, Allah, and whatever name you choose to refer to the great divine, masculine and feminine principle of the universe, we say Ashe.
Ashe.
Ashe. Next, now we want to call on those spiritual forces that God created to help man and woman realize your God consciousness here on earth. We'll start with the Great Mother, as known in the religion of Ifa of the Yorubas of West Africa, Yemoja. We say Ashe.
Ashe.
Her divine number is 7. Her colors is blue and white, closely related to Yemoja. We're calling that force known as Olokun Ashe. Olokun is that masculine energy of the deep, dark water. He's the father of the unconscious. His number is also 7. It's said that Yemoja and Olokun work together. Next, we call on Yemoja's younger sister. Her name is Oshun Ashe. Her divine number is 5. Her colors is the colors of honey, gold, and brown. She's the energy of the rivers, the lakes, and the streams, responsible for childbirth, responsible for physical attraction, sexual attraction, presence, and the aura that we carry around with us. Next, we call on the great feminine force of the wind. Her name is Oya Ashe. Oya brings the change. She guards the cemeteries. She's the queen of the marketplace. Her number is 9. She wears a skirt of 9 colors, symbolizing death, but not death in a negative sense, but death in a positive sense, because from death comes reincarnation and regeneration. Ashe. Next, we call on that divine aspect of metal, of war. His colors are green and black. His number is 3. He's known as the god Ogun. Ashe. Ogun is that energy we call on when we need some energy to perk us up. When we're coming up with a new invention, we need a new car, we gotta take an airplane flight. We wanna make sure that plane gets safely to where it's gonna go. We call on Ogun. Next, we call on Ogun's brother, Ochozi Ashe. Ochozi is the energy that helps us track our goals, track our spiritual progress. Indeed, next we want to call on Eshu Alekba Ashe. Eshu is the youngest of the Orisha, but one of the most powerful. His colors are black and red. His number is 3. He owns the keys to Ashe and the keys to all past. And you can only communicate to any other Orisha by first communicating with Eshu Alekba Ashe. Then, of course, we can call on Baba Luaye. He's the energy of health and the energy of the disease. He can make you sick, he can also make you healthy. Ashe.
Ashe.
And there's so many Orisha, so many Loa, so many Letcher, so many Abusa. We can never know them all, but we can feel them all. And we have the right, the divine right, to communicate with those Orisha to help us reach our spiritual goals. Ashe.
Ashe.
Next, you want to call on our bloodline ancestors, those of your family who have went on and went to the next level, and now they up in the ancestral realm. So now I ask you to call some of the names of your living dead. Give me some of your nieces and nephews and grandparents, brothers and sisters and cousins who you have lost. Give me some names. Ashe, give me some more. Ashe, who do you call? Ashe, who do you call? Ashe, build up that power. Who do you call? Ashe, who do you call? Masculine and feminine, young and old. Who do you call?
Ernest Gary.
Ashe, all right, now we want to go. Ashe, now we want to go to the Ogun. These are our collective African racial ancestors who you may not be related to. I start with Queen Mother Harriet Tubman. Ashe, who do you call? Ashe, who do you call? Ashe, Sojourner Truth, who do you call? Ashe, who do you call? Ashe, who do you call? Louis Latimer, Ashe, who do you call?
Khalid Muhammad.
Queen Zinga, Ashe, who do you call?
Yes,
Ashe, who do you call? Ashe, make sure you don't name no sellouts. Ashe, who do you call? Ashe, Ashe, Ashe. All right. Bless, 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 and blessings. Of course, in your home, you should all have an altar, an ancestral altar, a nice tree, plant, some fruit, white candles, some incense, a vessel of water, You should go to that altar every morning and invoke your ancestors to go to work with you, get in the car with you. They're there for you, but you don't use them. Stop calling those little naked angels that you was raised on in Sunday school. Little white boy with big penises hanging out, supposed to come and help you with wings on your back. Not true at all. Not true at all.